The Los Angeles County District Attorney's Office declined on Thursday, September 24th, to file a case against a reporter pinned to the ground, handcuffed and taken into custody by sheriff's deputies while covering the arrest of a demonstrator. Prosecutors cited insufficient evidence against Josie Huang of KPCC Enlaced, noting that it does not appear that she was intentionally attempting to interfere with the deputies. Prosecutors said she also was not given the opportunity to comply with their demand to back up on September 13 outside St. Francis Hospital in Linwood, where the two wounded deputies were being treated after being shot while sitting in a patrol SUV in Compton. It also appears that at least one deputy heard her say she was a reporter because he can be heard to say, "Do what you're told if you're a reporter," prosecutors wrote in the charge evaluation worksheet. Ms. Huang was in a public area filming a protest. The Los Angeles County Sheriff's Department claimed Huang didn't have proper media credentials, failed to properly identify herself as a reporter, and was interfering with a lawful arrest of one of the protesters. Sheriff Alex Villanueva later doubled down on that contention, saying Huang got right up on the shoulder of a deputy trying to make an arrest, and calling her actions more activism than journalism. Video from Huang's cell phone subsequently surfaced, showing her repeatedly identifying herself as a reporter, shouting, "KPCC," and saying, "You're hurting me," and crying out in apparent pain. Inspector General Max Huntsman, who is investigating Huang's arrest, has said he is still waiting to receive materials from the Sheriff's Department to conduct a more thorough probe. However, he questioned the veracity of statements by Villanueva and the department about the arrest. "Unfortunately, all evidence we have currently gathered suggests that significant parts of the claims made by the Sheriff's Department may have been false," Huntsman told the Civilian Oversight Commission. "The information we have gathered is preliminary and not intended to substitute for a complete investigation." The Reporters Committee for Freedom of the Press, a coalition of 64 media organizations, also called on the Sheriff's Department to drop the citation it issued to Huang, who spent about 5 hours in custody. The group echoed concerns expressed by other media groups that have disputed Villanueva's version of the arrest, and called on the department to take immediate steps to prevent another incident like the arrest of Huang. The letter from the Reporters Committee for Freedom of the Press accused deputies of violating Huang's constitutional rights. "The right to record police activity in public is clearly established, and an officer who violates that First Amendment freedom, especially through the use of force, enjoys no legal immunity," the group contends in the letter.